What's going on, everybody? Beveragi here. Thank you for joining the channel for High School Musical, the series. This is season 2, episode 1, and I have been anticipating this for over a month now, about a month and a half, as I watched and enjoyed so much more than I could have ever possibly expected. And I talked a lot about this, actually a lot. I had a really long recap of how I felt about the season as a whole when I finished the season finale of season 1. And I had a long recap for a reason, because the show made me feel so many things. I was just so, just genuinely surprised in the best way, the best kind of way. So yeah, I did do a large recap, so I just want to dive into the season 2, because I'm so anxious to know what's going to happen. And I know I'm not going to get all my answers in the first episode. Like, obviously we have to have some kind of arc, right? We can't just have Nini go to the school and have Ricky just be so upset right away and then make up. And even if they do make up, I have no clue. I don't know what they're going to do with this show. I don't know. But I know there's going to be some feelings going on with Ricky, and I'm just so curious. That's the only place my head is at right now. There's a lot of other stuff going on, yeah, but like, that's the big stuff. So let's just jump in. I'm ready. Really quick update. I know that this is coming out week to week. I'm not going to be, well, if you're watching this on YouTube, you already know this right now. But I'm only going to be uploading these to Patreon week to week. And fully uncut. So when the season ends, I'm going to actually edit my reactions to the whole season into one video. Obviously, it's going to be very cut up because it has to be. YouTube's rules. So if you do want to see like every single episode fully uncut, no cuts whatsoever, it's gonna be a lot more footage. You can check out my Patreon, the link is in the description, or you could just stick here and watch my very professionally edited version. Well, we'll see about that. All right, but yeah, with all that being said, let's start it up. This one's called New Year's Eve, which I don't even know what that. Oh, isn't that, that's the movie starts off, like the first movie starts off, and it's New Year's Eve, and there's like the countdown going on, and the romantic, potentially doesn't, it didn't end up being romantic, but like outside of the party that's going on. Ooh, okay, I see what they're doing with that. All right, let's jump right in, everyone. Here we go.
Okay, is everyone at places?
Hanging around the fire when it starts to snow, bumping in the summer. Hey! Our favorite couple. Getting comfy in my onesie. Yeah. Let's kick back and take a break. Did that run? There's no time to manage. Man, they put a lot of effort into that. That was so well done. Everyone's invited. It is Ashlyn. All right. So Gina's living with Ashlyn now, cuz I know she all she is.
See you later on today.
She hasn't told him yet.
Today ending in the letter Y, so I just kind of hope we be hanging out.
The girl who has never been to a sleepover before, and now I'm going to have like 100 of them in a row.
That's awesome.
But whatever, it's not a big deal. It's just like...
It's a big deal for you because you were moving all the time. It's so nice watching this and knowing all their backstories, like having all the emotion behind it. As opposed to like watching season 1, episode 1.
Into the spring musical. Because at the end of the day, it's all about.
Oh, I gotta watch the second movie now. Like, now. We'll do that.
Hi.
We'll do that.
Would you like us to sing a Christmas carol for you?
What now?
I was gonna tell you after the holiday, it's just to a smaller apartment.
Oh.
I'm the worst at wrapping things.
Same. Sleep more.
You know, first Christmas without her. But you're here.
Oh, look at them. They're gonna make me cry. Come on.
This is your gift. I hope it fits, because you can't return
it. I'm sure it'll fit.
This song's the second best that I could do when the perfect gift is you.
We love it. And perfect because... Whoa! I mean, let's...
I'm serious.
much.
Let's.
That's a lot, Ricky.
That's very nice of you, but...
Thanks. You gotta stay fighting shit. It's like the one thing I can always count on.
They're making it so much harder. They're doing that on purpose, obviously, but it's so much.
You're my home.
Oh, come on. He just said literally like 6 things that make it impossible for her to tell him right now. She obviously has to wait a day or what. Just tell him.
Dude, you're totally gonna get the part. You look like Shawn Mendes and you sing like Shawn Mendes.
Oh, we have a lot of pop culture references in this episode between
whatever.
Harry Styles and Shawn Mendes.
Whatever.
Two of my top boys.
What's going on with Ashley? We're down a delivery boy. Tonight,
New Year's Eve
is a big moneymaker for us.
Oh, I no. I mean, the pizza place can't be open till midnight, right?
You got to splash some throb before you show up. Bet on it.
He's just got to come smelling like some pepperonis.
You?
Sweetie, use your inside voice.
I'm Mexican and gay. This is my inside voice.
Uh-oh, getting nervous, Oscar?
Why wouldn't we do HSM2? Our HSM was instantly legendary.
Give it all I got, that is my plan. Will I find what I lost you?
No. I had it all written out and everything. My speech about going to Denver. Guess what song Ricky wanted to sing for me the entire ride over?
Can't bet on it, bet on it. You can bet on me.
I gotta see, Zac Efron sing that song.
I'm getting a root beer. Anyone want anything?
I'm okay.
Wait, I don't like to go back, but hold on. What the hell is that? You know that he's happy. Oh, come on. That's going to be a thing this year? And then Nini's going to leave?
After my little run-in with Zachy today?
No.
I Googled the Minkyu.
My father and our grandpa before him also go to Duke. Guys, I think it's just a matter of time.
Okay, I lost track of the air quotes.
Some problem is going to derive from this.
I resolve to follow my dreams however far away they take me.
No. That's how he's going to find out?
It's me, actually.
Pizza delivery from Big Red.
Pizzas. 2 with lactose-free cheese.
Yeah, bring in the queen.
You are the music in me.
That's my cousin.
From the knee to the melody, echoing inside my head.
Gina, why are you doing this now? You already know.
Like a common thread.
I have an announcement.
You cut your hair.
That's not the announcement.
I'm so glad they got their kissing.
Contrary to rumor,
she's gonna write on their parade.
We are not. Beauty and the Beast.
I actually love that.
And
so much.
Win the most. We are entering the Alan Menken Awards for High School Musical Theater.
Pressure's on.
Beauty and the Beast?
That's all right.
Okay, I need to study the text.
You just need a castle and a library.
So who is ready to show the world they can already picture you in Belle's gold dress?
That's right. She would kill that so much.
Ricky, I'm moving to Denver.
No, not here. Okay, it's clearly, okay. All right. Wow, that is, so I hate that she just told him in front of everybody, but I get it. Dramatic effect, right? I had to do that. Oh, my guy's going to be hurting after this. And they built up the fact that he'd be hurting so much. But can we talk about this episode? This was so strong. This was so strong. Like, not only was the camera work, the production, I don't know if they have a new director, whatever's going on, like, the cinematography of this episode was definitely improved on season one. And it was fine in season one, but, like, nothing where I would notice that's, you know, over the top good. But there's definitely something extra going on here, and I'm all here for it. Because hopefully that gets it more attention than it deserves to much more people that maybe wouldn't have watched it otherwise, because this show is so good. Like, this show, I feel like anyone could watch this show that isn't even interested in, like, that kind of, like, a show centered on high school and music and teenage relationships. Like, that's not a large demographic, but I feel like you could have someone else watch it that's not interested in that and find something to enjoy, because I just think it's great, but you all know that. Okay. The Gina looking over a couple different times at Ricky in this way where she's definitely feeling some kind of way about Nini and Ricky. I gotta get used to saying the names again. I keep wanting to say, like, Joshua, Olivia, but we'll get there. We'll get there now that we're watching every single week again. That kind of stresses me out a little bit, because if Nini does actually leave, and she's gonna leave, right? She has to. It's her dream. I'd be concerned that I just hope that Nini and Ricky don't have any long distance problems, and that turns into like a Gina was there for him situation, you know, and then Nini, I don't even want to think that into existence, because that would be such a bummer, because I like Nini and Ricky together. I know that Ricky was there for Gina, and that probably has a lot to do with it. Because no one else really was. Like, she was such a loner. Man, the show's got me thinking so... I'm such a fan of this. You know what? Let's just... You guys know how I feel. This was so well done. Like I said, they covered everything, which is so impressive, by the way, for them to jump into the episode and, like, cover pretty much every single thing that's going on, like, within each interpersonal situation, like Big Red and Ashlyn and his Ricky's father. They even introduced something going on with him where, and it makes sense, right? Single dad, like, a lot of bills going on, obviously. They even covered the fact that the teachers wouldn't be fired, which I forgot about, because of the fire. Like, they made sure to kind of cover that, which is important. They didn't leave that plot hole empty. EJ got some coverage. Like, every single plot hole was, like, wrapped up a bit, and now they've opened up a whole new can of worms here with a bunch of different things, and oh man, I can't wait, and it sucks that we gotta wait week to week now, but the episodes will be here every week. I believe they come out, I don't know what day of the week they come out, but they won't, I'll have them up a day or two after, no later than that.
Yes, of course I wish Nini had told me about boarding school soon.
I get it.
Honestly, can you blame her?
I get it.
I mean, the last time she told me she was going away, I said I wanted to take a pause.
Hey, I said if you cried, I was gonna cry.
I'm not crying, okay? I'm just allergic to my girlfriend going to Colorado without me.
So crazy to watch this scene after season one episode.
You're going to make this long distance thing look easy.
Turning into a man in front of our eyes. That's how it's done, Ricky.
I believe I'm standing in front of both Troy Boltons right now. Both their performances last semester in HSM were incredible.
Who is this?
Gina. Living with you is the closest I've ever come to having a sister, and Court, I know Nini must be feeling like a long-lost sister right now, so...
Look at these three.
We could audition as a girl group.
Oh, Little Mix Part 2!
Is the Vibe Destiny's Child, or is the Vibe Cheetah Girl?
Dude, I don't think you've ever disappointed anyone in your whole life.
Damn.
You know what actually make me feel a lot better?
Love that line.
Knowing you were gonna... Maybe I won't audition for the show this semester.
Wait, are you serious?
I don't know. It's just kind of hard to picture doing a show without you.
And he's being honest about it.
You're kind of like my rock.
I'm so proud of him.
Hey.
So I wonder if we'll get scenes of her in Colorado, or it'll just be these FaceTime scenes. I can't. No, she's too important to the show.
Last minute jitters.
Only be on FaceTime.
I want adventure in the great white somewhere. I want it more than I can.
Wow.
All right.
We have an X Factor on the stage here.
We have to sing for two people.
Wow. Holy shit.
Dorothea, I am bound to inform you of what you...
Does that ever make you feel like you're being put in a box?
Oh, I meant I had never done local theater before.
You know, with this kind of crowd.
No.
What are you trying to say?
That we both know we're the only real contenders for the lead here.
Here we go. She's gonna be one of these characters.
My friends are incredibly talented.
Gina.
I'm sorry. Thought this was an audition, not a friendship circle.
Wow.
Good luck.
Stop. What's going on here?
I'm so sorry.
Oh, no, it was my idea. We thought it'd be interesting to interpret the scene in our own words for this exercise.
It's an audition, not an exercise.
Aw, damn.
Yeah, Emily, would you care to enlighten Nina?
Nina?
At Yak, there's no such thing as a warm-up or an exercise.
Oh, it is
every
Nina,
moment
isn't
is an
it?
Audition.
They call her Nina because of Ricky.
Enlightening me, Emily. I guess I was just thinking part of what's cool about being an actor here is we get to stretch ourselves and, I don't know, like, take big risks.
That's what was cool about where she just was, but now
thank
she's...
you. Let's try this again tomorrow when you two are better prepared.
Ladies, now I'm ready for the spotlight. No doubt about it, yeah, I think it's finally my time. See my name shine free. 1, 2, 3. Power individually.
This is very Little Mix, like DNA Little Mix.
Recipe, mix the spicy with the sweet, with the sweet, yeah.
Go ahead, Ashlyn.
Seriously?
You got this, dude.
No.
Breathe. Just breathe. Okay?
Oh, got you. Friendship.
Damn.
Yeah. Go ahead. Big Red, perfect. Oh my god, that got me. Ricky just so immediately coming to Red's aid. Even though Ricky was down himself, it doesn't matter when it comes to friendship. The fuck? Is that? That's how it sounds?
Lear!
Not get a part?
I got the part.
Yes!
You mean?
I got Belle.
Yes!
I'm Belle.
Oh, yes. Fuck yes.
You've got an incredible voice.
Good job, Miss Jen.
But... around here, we don't laugh at people who put themselves out there,
okay.
Even when they look a little...
Okay. You are looking at East High's newest beast.
Really?
Roar! Are you allowed to make noises on vocal rest?
Oh, whatever. This is way more important. My amazing and talented boyfriend just got the lead.
The YC.
It's perfect.
Captains of our noble...
It's so fucking smart. Have her sing her own version.
Set the bar and raise our star shining through and through.
As she looks miserable.
The North High School main switchboard. Please state the teacher or department you are trying to reach.
Drama.
I don't know what her... She's watching them and trying to get a hold of the drama teacher? Miss Jen? I mean, she's obviously up to something bad. Up to something no good, but I can't even guess what she could try and pull off there. I don't know. Yeah, I have no idea, but I'm curious to see what she tries to do and how that's going to be like a conflict that arises and that they have to overcome. I love that she didn't get a part. I did not see that coming. Like, I just assumed that she would get Belle because, again, like, that's just what would have been like a very stereotypical story arc to have the new evil girl come in and just get like the role, like the main role, because she's so talented. But then like she just has even more power now to add to her evilness because she's been given this main role. That would have been interesting, but it also would have been obvious. They completely threw me for a loop and it showed what matters. Like it keeps the like this dynamic that all these people have, all the students have, is that. Aside from the fact that they're all just so talented, that they have a great relationship with each other. It's like based off of kindness and being there for each other, like in every way, not just physically, but like mentally and emotionally. And for her to come in and be so different from all of them in that way, like in the worst way, she sticks out like a sore thorn, like so obviously. And I'm so like Miss Jen just, and it makes sense too, because they built that up, like Miss Jen at the bowling alley, like Miss Jen in every way has been a part of that to an extent. Like she was saved by all the kids. Literally her job was saved by all of these students. So it is so clutch and makes so much sense. Yet I was thinking they'd go the obvious way. So I'm so happy they did that. I love the three-way grouping of Courtney, Ashlyn, and Gina. I mentioned it, and I was saying it, but I didn't want to, like, interrupt the song because it was getting so into, like, that whole, like, Little Mix Spice Girls thing they were going for. Meets drag, I think he said, but like I said, I'm not sure what that is because I haven't seen or heard that, whatever it is. But, yeah, I love what works so much about it is that they did such a perfect job in season one of subtly building up each of those characters so that now you have Nini not in the school, so you have to put your focus on, like, other characters a little bit more, and now you have the three of them kind of in that group. Not that they're going to be in a group going forward, but just you really put focus on the three of them and how important they are, how talented they are, how special they are as people, especially because the three of them contrast, I didn't get that new girl's name, but they contrast her so significantly because she's so different from them, again, in the worst way. She's just a terrible person. And I'm also wondering if she'll have, like, an arc where, because this show's incredible with character arc. Like, Ricky, look at Ricky, I'm so proud of him. He's just, like, being completely vulnerable with Nini, which he was completely incapable of doing when this show started. And immediately, like, he just buys her that globe from Home Goods. Like, he tells her how he feels right away. Doesn't hold things back, which is the, like, part, what he used to do, which was, like, a part of the huge problem. The Ricky and Big Red, like, I literally cried at that when he just came and swooping in to help him, even though he just had a shitty audition. Also interesting enough that Ricky got the Beast part, which is the co-star of the movie. Ricky got that part and he had a bad audition, and it just goes to show that, you know, Miss Jen's going more off of what she knows he can do more so than, like, what he just did. And I also love that. It shows how much faith she has in him. I really appreciate that. But it's so interesting. This episode had so much in it. Am I going to keep saying, like, every episode? Like, this one is the best one I think I've seen yet. When you count everything, when you count the arc of everything, how much things make sense, where they went instead of where I thought they'd go, but, like, for the best. The Nini thing, how she, like, the whole, she's a square peg in a star-shaped hole or whatever, that's kind of a good thing. And that's what she likes. Like, she likes to experiment and kind of be unique in her own way. And she was able to do that in the school. She can't do that here. And I found it so interesting that it was, like, so fucking perfect that at the end there, the way that fucking school anthem was sung, like, she sang it so differently in her own way. And I love that she did that there at the end, even though she looked really sad. I obviously have a lot of thoughts, a lot of feelings. I can't wait for next week's episode. I love that each episode doesn't just feel like an episode where they're just, it's like, okay, let's get to the season finale already. Because a lot of shows do that. This show doesn't do that at all, especially with these first two episodes. And even last season, they didn't do that at all. Like, every episode is so special on its own. And that's so important. This show's really stepped it up. Wow. And again, that's with me loving last season. Ooh, we love Ricky. Oh, no, not Ricky. I should have known by the ukulele sound that it was Nini. She's home.
So I thought it would be fun to take a quick break from Yak, come back home, and...
Yeah, you know she wanted to get away from there.
When we were...
I think of you when the wind blows.
She got the mic and speaker set up and everything. She's such a keeper. What? All right. Oh,
what are you doing?
You
what
moved.
Am I doing? Who are you being?
Who are you being?
Where is Ricky?
He moved, right? He didn't tell her that he moved.
Who?
A new girl from Salt Lake.
Oh, I'm pretty sure she cut out a day early for the weekend.
Oh.
You weren't going to do that outdoor serenade thing, were you?
What's wrong with that?
You realize this is a drunk test.
Why you got to kill his...
Cool.
Kill his vibes.
I'm gonna get
they probably miss each other so much. It's been so long, and then... It sucks.
Apologize for taking up space.
Let's go.
This place could use a Courtney's touch. It's messy.
Gonna want extra utensils.
Disgruntled employees.
Doesn't matter.
Why? About that.
Oh, it's all good. I only had like three nightmares about the girl in the window.
How does he keep that?
I spent all night freezing on the back of a bus.
How does she not know he moved?
Song.
I wrote a song too.
Of course they both did.
Oh, come on.
I want to hear yours right now.
In the hallway?
Oh, hey, we're starting. Miss Jen's asking for you.
Calling for the Beast, and it's not just because of Stockholm Syndrome, y'all. Love is
love. Hey, Baby, look what you've done for me. The waltz.
Let's take it way under tempo.
Now.
I want you to prepare yourself for a really special romantic surprise later today.
That defeats the purpose of the whole surprise.
But it's gonna be.
You are not good at this, Red, clearly.
Okay.
Which is fine, because you're Red. You just be yourself.
I got you a card.
He's overthinking it.
Yes. I remember you said you were sad you outgrew that old pine sled from your childhood.
Oh, we love thoughtful gifts. It's all about the thought.
Don't feel obligated to reciprocate.
Ye old farm.
Oh, no. He just made that up. What would he have from a farm? It's Valentine's Day. How are you not prepared for this?
Look,
it's Valentine's Day.
I know Ashton is super
down. Again.
Bring your ukulele, okay? I want to hear your song.
Yes, please bring it.
Of course. Yeah,
so here's the deal.
Hospital?
I'm in the emergency clinic with her right now. Can I come over around dinner?
Definitely, yeah.
They're going to keep having they're going to keep delaying the meeting up after all this time too. Like they miss each other so much.
At least I think I do. It's hard to say.
I like the dynamic of them two kind of having this side conversation here. Something different.
I told Carlos that I had a special present coming from my family.
That's your own fault, man.
Find something organic and just be you.
Thanks, Court.
That's it. I love everyone helping each other out. Like, they helped each other out. Gina helped out Ashlyn. Hopefully that works its way to everyone figuring these issues out in this episode. Joshua's voice is so soothing. I'm just such a fan of his tone. Especially when he's not pushed. I like when he pushes it. It sounds great also. But when he's just like right there, where it just comes out so easily.
Gina.
Why is she?
Hey. I'm sorry about this. I should have called. Valentine's Day is kind of hard for me this year.
You came to him to vent about Valentine's Day? About not having anyone on Valentine's Day?
Yeah, I get that.
Ricky's uncomfortable.
I'm missing your mom.
Yeah.
Tell you that I don't really tell anyone.
This is framed this way for a very specific reason. And then a little bit of a step there too.
Nini.
What are we doing here, guys?
Hey, Nini. Where are you?
So, turns out, Mom, you should call her back and play it over the phone.
Okay, that's like genuine friend advice.
Trust me on this, every girl likes a sweet gesture.
I think you'll get yours too.
I'll live.
No, you see?
Thank you for...
No. It's more... She's being a good friend, but then again, there's that look, and there's the sadness, and there's the walking away without really saying anything, and he's speaking, but she's already gone when he's still speaking. They're doing...
Oh, my goodness. Lily, fuck. You are quiet as a mouse.
Did it just get cold in here? They're really playing her out to be like an actual evil horror
Benjamin,
character.
Have you had dinner?
Whoa, Valentine's Day dinner? So she's gonna, someone commented about that they thought she was gonna go to the other school and then like,
hi.
To get the lead role and then win the award.
You're perfect, Ashlyn. I think you should play the princess in everything.
Oh, fake around.
No offense.
This guy's got me crying
feeling afraid?
Back to back episodes. He's just so genuine too, like he's not even just saying it.
Happy being afraid together.
Shipped them so hard. Why is like high school love making this grown ass man so mopey
like young love.
Over here?
Yeah, dirt.
I planted some organic seeds for my boy
more than dirt
about an hour ago. I thought maybe we could have something that grows with us.
That's awesome. That's so sentimental.
Passion.
Yes.
Conversation.
Okay, they're just friends.
Thank you. I'll try that.
Yeah, he's sad about that. That's so interesting because that's like Gina with Ricky. That situation, like that dynamic is so similar, the way they just played that. That's such good writing for this episode. Ricky didn't. He did not. He's being a good friend. He sure did run away really fast. I mean, yeah, it's a good friend, but... I hope that she doesn't feel misled. The talent on this show is crazy.
Both
head.
I see your face on the wow, this, this is so smart. Denver always seems so far away. Never giving up on you. Because they're both so damn talented. Got the chocolate fondant. No! Gina! I'm a Pisces, you're a Gemini. You're the brightest star in the east high sky. So while this show keeps getting me. This show just keeps on getting me. It's so interesting because this episode was... It felt like it was a lot slower. It just felt that way. Maybe it wasn't. I don't know. But it felt like it was a lot slower than the first two episodes. Well, the first two episodes felt like a lot more dramatic anyway and drama-filled. But in this one, we had like all the issues were happening, but with every single issue, Ricky and Nini... is different because if they have like I'm always worried about them because I know they're the two main characters and I would imagine they might want to add some kind of serious conflict at some point, and you already have such an easy place to add conflict considering she's so far away and all that, and now they're obviously introduced, like the Gina thing is a thing, she gave him good friend advice, but it's a thing, like she was hoping that he was the one that dropped her. Well, she not just hoping, like it made sense because he texted her and the chocolates were delivered, blah blah blah. She finds out it was her mom. I get that. But now they're gonna have to have that conversation like at some point. It's gonna be super awkward, and I would imagine it happens at the school. Also interesting how like most of this episode was outside of the school. We've gotten a lot of that all season actually, and I'm here for that. I feel like a lot of my favorite shows, I feel like I'm only thinking about The Office for some reason right now, but when The Office started to The Office was always great, but when it started to venture out more and more outside the office and we got more like scenes and episodes or even full episodes sometimes that were outside the office, I feel like it just added such a different dynamic to the show that was like needed. And it's interesting because the show's called The Office, yet you started to get more episodes that weren't in the office. I just found that like that dynamic was so necessary. Here the show's called High School, right? So you have all this stuff going on that's not in the high school. I think that dynamic is like really needed once again. It just like really adds to character growth and all that. I was never really worried about all the couples besides Nini and Ricky. Like you could pretty much tell they were going to resolve it. Not only that, everyone's such a great person. Like Carlos and Sebastian, Ashlyn and Big Red. Oh my God, I already fanned out enough and I fucking cried again over Big Red. He got me twice this season. Well, technically it was Ricky that got me because when he came to help Big Red. But still, like, Big Red was part of it. Still though, wow, I didn't expect twice in three episodes. I think I cried once last season, like in total, or maybe twice when Ricky was going through it with his parents. I was definitely, I think that was the only time actually, already twice. Okay. Yeah. You know what? I'm rambling. I really enjoyed this. I'm so curious to see what happens with the evil girl. And where she, like, I assume, I'm in the Patreon comments, someone guessed that she was going to go play the lead role and then beat, like, try and beat them for the award. Now that makes a lot of sense, and I'm going to assume the same thing's happening. So I'm curious to see that, but I'm probably mostly curious to see the Gina-Ricky thing and the dynamic of that. And if they're going to make that, like, an actual thing, like, if Ricky's going to have to be conflicted at any point with... Because he doesn't seem to have feelings for Gina at all. Like, he's very committed to Nini. I'm really curious about that whole thing, about what's going to happen there. Let me know how you... I love seeing all your guys' comments about how you felt about the episode and your ideas about where it's going.
I just can't believe you're leaving again today.
All right.
Two home-cooked dinners together wasn't enough.
I know.
And don't you forget about, you know, Salt Lake.
It's where she'd rather be. Well, she has... Yeah, exactly. That's what, it's Carlos and Gino.
I think the Feather Duster Brigade sounded cool.
Okay.
Really, really?
Yeah. What, do I need to send you a random box of chocolates to prove it?
Sick burn. So yeah, I sent an embarrassing text on Valentine's Day, but Ricky and I totally glued it up. Obviously, I would never step on what he has with Nini. It's all good.
Thank
it's
you.
It's actually kind of a running joke now between us.
And to be college students who are obviously...
Oh!
Nini! I don't want to interrupt. I just needed one more group hug.
Sharon, there's a fine line between fun and completely freaked out.
I live on that line.
This is such an interesting episode.
Caswell, you're not cavorting like the other show people.
Not really in a cavorting mood.
Something you want to talk about? Caltech. Shit. I applied 4.5 times. Never made the cut. All I ever wanted. All my dad ever wanted for me too.
Comfort. That's what it is. It's comfort from both teachers to students.
Attitudes on the house.
Look at this turnaround after he was a little bit of a brat in the last episode.
Is there something you're not saying?
Did you bring your snow globe?
Of course.
Go back to second guessing that world, but all I left behind has got me feeling so torn.
Okay.
Am I taking it for granted? Everything that I've been granted. I keep lying awake with these dreams. Oh, I feel shaken. Oh.
Wow, that's beautiful. She came back?
Oh, thank goodness. I thought you were another scary ghost girl.
It was crazy because I used to feel trapped here, but today I was really sorry I wasn't.
That's so ironic because everyone was trapped in because of the snowstorm. And she probably feels trapped in the other school.
So,
that's another great line.
What's the new dream?
Is it okay if I don't know yet?
Yeah, it's actually always okay.
Come on.
Ricky, where are you right now?
Why?
I wasn't loving this episode for like the first, I don't know, three quarters of it. I was enjoying it. Definitely wasn't bad. But the season's been so good. So fucking good so far. But like that last 10 minutes or so, whatever amount of time, right up there with the rest of the season. So well done. So well done. The whole car scene with Miss Jen and Nini. My favorite scene of the episode, right before those last 10 minutes, nothing's gonna top that music video for me. Like that's what it was basically—a music video where Ricky went to go see Nini at the bus stop, and and you know it like gets very cinematic all of a sudden, and then she goes into that song. You know what's interesting about that song? I was about to say it, but I didn't want to interrupt the song because it was so good. That song. Obviously, you could tell it was written kind of to be like, it sounds like it could be a hit. That's what it sounds like to me. So it sounds like much more than a song you would just find in a show that incorporates like musical type of music. That song was so different from everything on Olivia Rodrigo's album Sour. Like, way different. Like, Sour doesn't really have... Like, it's not super pop. It's got so many other elements on it. Like, it's got some pop, yeah, for sure. But it's not, like, just directly pop. That song was super pop, but I actually really, really liked it. I could totally hear it on the radio. And I could hear it on the album because it was so different. And because my favorite thing about Sour probably is that everything is so different. Like, there's just... I mean, we know. Like, Hope You're Okay, Good For You, Favorite Crime, like... You can go up and down and find so Deja Vu, like Driver's License, so epic. You can go up and down that album and find so many different sounds. I've been listening to Sour so much lately, by the way. It's crazy. I went on a long trip over the weekend, so I was away for a little bit, but we're back. And I played Sour a couple times over. It was just so, it's exactly what I needed. But point being, I just want to talk about that song for a second. I really enjoyed that song. And what's crazy about having a show like this and having, what's crazy about having a show like this is that your star of the show isn't just an actress. She's a singer, and she's not just a singer actress. She's like a legitimate top tier singer. Like, she's a top tier pop star. She's huge, and for a reason, because she's so good at what she does. And that dynamic is so interesting to me, because you forget about that sometimes when you're watching the show, because you get so caught up in the story of it all, that seeing a scene like that, it's like, yeah, this is Olivia Rodrigo here, by the way. Like, you can do things like that when you have an Olivia Rodrigo. You can incorporate an entire whole ass, like, pop radio hit. Like, that would be a hit right now, and make, turn it into like a little music video. Like, that's like a legit music video she just had going on there, and it was cinematically with the snow and the bus, and then the you know, Olivia's so good at acting during these things too, like the music videos that she's done on the three that she has. Yeah, I just want to get that point across, because I'm such a fan of her, and seeing things like that just reminds me. Like, I watch a lot of this show and spend a lot of time thinking about her music career. I separate them in my head as I'm watching. I don't really think, and that's props to the show, because there's so many great characters and great storylines that I don't really need to think about that. But then I get reminded when things like that happen. That might be like my favorite thing I've heard so far, musically speaking, like as a whole, including that little music video part there. And yeah. So yeah, I loved how this got wrapped up. And the only question I have now is, what's good with this? There is no resolution for the Gina stuff whatsoever. We're like flatlining. We got nothing. Like, Ricky, this is not his problem, right? This is so one-sided. He's not even thinking about this. He's glad that it got cleared up, and he's making jokes about it. He's done with it. Like, he's still openly talking to Gina about Nini, like, when he asked her about, should I send the text? Not that he wanted to do that. Red put him on the spot. But, like, he's not even thinking, like, oh, Gina doesn't want to hear this, because he's not concerned about that. And Gina she just needs to realize that. Like, she's out of place. She's out of line, honestly, in my opinion. Maybe other people disagree. Let me know if you disagree. I'd love to hear your opinions. I know I got some opinions in the last episode about it, which I loved. But just the fact that it's still going, even though we talked about all this. Gina just keeps... I don't know. I can't wait to see where it all goes. What's curious to me is I felt like it was going to be an obvious breakup because of the distance. That's where I felt like it was going, but she's staying home now. So why would they break up now? Like, what would you do to cause them to break up? Is it going to be a Gina situation? I don't know how I would feel about that. Because they're not going to break up because of distance now. So maybe they don't break up. You know? All right, guys. All right. I am going to have the High School Musical 2 movie up before I film the next episode.
What?
Why do I hear sheep but don't see sheep?
Oh, that's Jimmy. He has social anxiety.
Well,
they're on his Seb's farm.
I don't camp, I don't glamp, I don't even sleep without a silk pillowcase.
Respect.
I like where you're headed.
It's good to see them back together, like physically back together.
I got this. I've only been back for 2 weeks, and it is the best.
She's already back at home.
I'm with my favorite people in the world doing what I love best. Coming up with an awesome plan and then just doing it.
Speaking of candles, if they were real, there would be 16 of them this weekend. Like the movie?
Well, that movie was about something, Seb.
It's my birthday weekend, but I don't like just telling people that.
16. Because, like, so are they juniors?
How thirsty am I, you know?
It's a question
but
I've had for a
I'm
bit.
I'm not above dropping a hint or two.
Two creams, four sugars.
Oh, the enemy.
You are so predictable.
Scalding hot black coffee. I see what they... And she just... She's the devil. But she's
so
back.
Fun to watch.
Put her in the show. She's back.
So much fun.
There's got to be something she can
I'm
do.
I'm here too. Sort of adjacent to the fun having.
You gotta have her. That's not even an option.
Maybe it's a sign. I should just focus on making new music and do my own solo thing.
Okay. That's fair.
If I'm in rehearsals and you're off doing your solo thing, when will we see each other?
We see each other all the time, Ricky.
What are you talking about?
It's not that deep of fun and trying new stuff.
Don't do that.
All right, let's load up, guys.
Don't do that, Ricky.
Are you sure?
Yeah, Ricky's very needy. But there's reason. There's lot very logical reasons for that. They just gotta have that. They gotta have that conversation. Because that was not the appropriate response, I feel like.
save me a dance tonight?
You got it.
Hey, okay, all right. I thought they were just going to drop that after the end of last season.
Hey, Gina, you got a second?
I'm here for it.
I have a proposal to run past you.
Yeah?
Do you think it's a crazy idea if I talk to Miss Jen about getting Nini into the show somehow? Would she be flattered?
Yeah, Ricky, I'd be flattered.
Okay, cool. You're the best.
That's not her actual...
But we aren't.
Sorry?
Maybe there are better people to confide in about Nini. I'm just saying, tonight's about Carlos. And I want to go out big.
Capture the joy.
This is so awkward. Okay.
Yes, Jane!
It's time to turn it up. Let the music take over your body and dance. Weather has won. It don't matter who you are. When we dance, we're all stars. Different in so many ways.
They stepped it up. I love the Spanish culture, like going... It's kind of salsa.
You asking how I was feeling?
Is that okay?
She hasn't gotten that from Ricky because all he does is talk to her about Nini and not her, like ever. Oh, Miley Cyrus! Oh, let's go! Sorry.
I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle.
Wow.
Sometimes I'm gonna have to.
Oh my gosh.
It's the climb. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, nice open, yes. Joe Serafini? Joe Serafini? Sir? Wow?
Sorry, what?
Oh.
Nothing.
Oh. Is that a thing? Is that a thing?
Hi, in our brand new production of Beauty and the Beast.
I told you guys, she should not have told him.
In the big...
I'm ready to come home.
She's leaving, yeah. I had a feeling she was she dropped a lot of hints the whole episode, like last... time this, last time that. All right. So I want to save the Gina thing for a second. A couple things. The Ricky response to Nini is something that hit me really quickly because I just didn't think it was a great response on his part. I'm not surprised by it because it's kind of his personality. But they seem to completely forget to like make it not a thing as it went on and on and on. And then there, as she like offered Nini like a role, Nini was like smiling and. Like, oh, like, she didn't seem like she was, like, nervous as far as, like, oh, I don't want to do it, really. I assume it's just not going to be a thing. Whatever, I'll put it in my head. I thought it was definitely going to be a thing at some point. Because I'm kind of waiting for them to do the obvious thing. Where it's, they create some kind of divide between Nini and Ricky. And having her come back home did the complete opposite, actually. Which I said in the last episode, I think. So I guess I'm just, I'm still kind of waiting for them to do that, but... The show has surprised me a lot with not doing the super obvious and genuinely keeping me kind of surprised, like left and right, which has been one of my favorite things about it. Another thing, I love the genuine friendships. It speaks a lot to the actors, of course, but you can tell they're actually friends off set. Like a lot of the cuts to like Carlos, Seb, I mean, obviously what was going on in this episode, but like Courtney, even like Ricky and Nini, like as you're cutting to them, as Carlos is having everything presented to him and like everything, like they're all kind of talking to him and about him. And then he goes up to talks and, you can tell that like they have an actual friendship off camera. Like to me, it's very obvious. Like it's almost like they don't fully have to act, in a lot of the scenes. When it comes to just like really appreciating and just showing like real genuine friendship for one another. And I really love that. Another thing, the songs. Wow. I think I said it how I felt about both, mainly Seb's performance. That was, oh my god, that was That's something I need to like download. I think they released downloads of some of the songs. That's something I need to download and listen to at some point. All right. And then the moment with Gina with like crazy. One thing about this season I've noticed is the songs are great last season, like fantastic. But they've not only stepped it up this season, every song feels like a moment. Like it feels like everything slows down and it's this kind of epic theatrical like moment for the show. And that's something I've really appreciated about this season. We have like five different moments where it's not just like a song that happened in the show. It's like, no, this is a moment. This is like something that's going to live in the history and memory of the audience that watches this show. So I've loved that about this. So I really enjoyed the Gina and EJ interactions. Because it really shed some very clear light. Like, I had an idea kind of what was going on, but to me, the show didn't do, like, a great job. Like, you can definitely assume, and you can use your human judgment and empathy and assume kind of what the show is doing based on, like, a human life situation. But I didn't feel like the show was doing the best job at showing that Gina was more so looking at Ricky and, like, this like, oh, I want my friend back sort of light. Like, to me, the show made it look a little bit more weird than that. And that's on the show. But what I really enjoyed about these scenes is that it was very clear. It was like, she's talking to EJ, like EJ asked her how she's doing. And that was so enlightening to her. Like, wow, someone actually asked me, because you have Ricky coming to her once again with more Nini issues where she never asked her how she's doing ever. It's just always like, hey, you know, blah, blah, blah. I need your help with this and this and that and this and that. And then she kind of opened up to him about that. Like, hey, I'm not your girlfriend comment. That was confusing because she said, go vent to someone else about it. Let's go back to it, actually.
Reason?
Okay, this right here.
Wouldn't you be flattered?
Yeah, Ricky, I'd be flattered.
Okay, cool. You're the best.
But we aren't.
Sorry?
We aren't dating.
Obviously.
So maybe there are better people to confide in about Nini.
Okay, so this could just be, like, to me, bad writing in this specific scenario because he's using a hypothetical, like, if we were dating. Like, I understand that kind of question to ask a friend. Makes sense on his part. Even though, like, he's wrong for completely, like, being oblivious to her needs as a friend. And that's been made obvious in this episode. And looking back, it's like, all right, Ricky, you know, you're not really... you haven't been there for her like at all. You don't, not even that you have to be like her best friend, but you're totally worried about your own stuff. But here, for her to say we aren't, maybe you should confide in someone else. Well, he's not dating anyone else except Nini. So I'm kind of nitpicking. Logically speaking, from a writing standpoint, it doesn't make sense. It could just be her being upset and just speaking. I guess not even bad writing. It could just be her being upset and just saying that, even though it doesn't make total sense. Because then he'd have to confide in someone he was dating who's not Nini, who's not her, which is just not logical. But she's just upset, though. And she has every right to be upset based on things that I already said over and over and over again. So I found that really interesting. I kind of saw it happening where they were leading up to her going back home, because she dropped a couple hints here and there about this being it or something like she said something with the idea of like finality to it a couple times. And the EJ thing with her, is that if she's gonna leave, how would they make that a thing? It felt random, but it makes sense because I already said EJ, Nini, Ricky, Gina. But he was definitely looking like extra, where it seemed like it was more than a friend camera shot to his face. Either way, I really liked this episode a lot. This is up there. There's like been two or three episodes this season that to me are like perfect. And this is right up there with those. And this season is just like, I've said it over and over again. Like, they stepped it up. All right, y'all. I'm out of here because I've been going on for a while. But that's what the show does for me. It makes me think. There's just like other stuff that happened in this show too. Like with Miss Jen and the kind of triangle there, but we touched on that during the episode.
Your next, chérie, because we are coming to slay.
Nos bougies sont réelles.
Oh, wow.
Sont pures.
It's getting real.
Oh my gosh, that's what's her name? Lily from our auditions.
Slowly.
She isn't just co-directing their show, she's starring.
But we have something North High doesn't.
Friendship.
A brand new original song.
Olivia
for
Rodrigo.
The Beast and the Rose.
That's
Everything I write is mush. I keep trying to write something about how the beast sees the rose as like this symbol for love slipping away, but nothing's working.
Here come these two again.
The Robinsons order pizza 3 times a week. I think I know whether it's drive or road.
Howard?
Hey,
no.
Do you wanna?
Is this?
Got it.
She's just blatantly not talking to him. And then here's this.
Team Wonderstudy. Yeah, I got you.
Okay, wow.
Oh, this is like 10 texts in a row from Ricky.
What is this?
I sent him a selfie of me eating pizza.
Okay.
And he was like, why are you eating pesto and not Hawaiian?
Okay.
I texted him back that I actually only eat Hawaiian because he likes it, and now he thinks that I'm changing.
Are we starting the divide this way?
To say the song
between these two?
Great.
Well, what is your heart telling you?
Oh.
I really don't know.
What's in your heart, and then you cut to Ricky. It's just a very interesting.
Okay. Let's try a new pair.
Choices.
I'd ask my future self if he's still as happy as I am right now.
Man, Ricky definitely does need to take some notes from his father.
Same.
Because he is just all over the place.
I'd ask him if he could ever learn to love anyone after Belle. I mean, anything's possible, right?
DJ getting deep. Wow. That's a deep answer.
Suppose I was.
Gina.
After the show, we didn't get a Gina scene. Are we going to a flashback? So a lot of this we literally just haven't known about.
I'll catch up. Gotta get some of this makeup off.
This is what we've needed. I didn't know we were going to do a flashback at any point. I just assumed that wasn't going to ever be a thing on this show.
I guess I just want to say that. I'm sorry, this is so stupid. I don't know why I'm crying. I wouldn't quit on us if I wasn't moving away. So now, I'm gonna give you a really tight hug, and then I'm gonna walk away with my head held high.
You told him that?
Yeah, the plane was going down.
Well, have you talked about it since then?
I mean, Nini's back, and he's so happy now.
You want to come up here and do the 5 questions?
Oh, everyone is just down. Every single person is not in the mood for any of this.
Far away, home is too. What I give to return back.
Oh, and they both come in.
Am I here for a day or forever?
Aw. Gina needed that. She needs more than that, but that's definitely a great start.
Okay, that's how I feel. How do you feel?
No games. We love that. Do not play games, sir.
Like a Gryffindor?
Brave?
Who... maybe he found his Ravenclaw.
Oh no, the Harry Potter references. Just take my heart right now.
I've spoken to your dad. We both agreed it's best if we don't see each other again.
Oh.
Theater is a safe space. Have you spoken to your mom?
We haven't talked in a minute.
I bet she misses hearing from you.
Just Miss Jenna is just so clutch. She's so wise and she's just so great.
You love me, but for all the wrong reasons. Am I something to you?
She's so special. There's nothing that I haven't said about her through the album reaction and song reactions and via this show. She is just a special, special human and artist and songwriter. I know she wrote the song. I saw that. like using the exact concept of that rose and the entrapment that it's in Beauty and the Beast and creating an entire song about that. It's just so smart, and like it's so easy to write that song and go into the direction of like from the Beast's perspective, like she said, but no, she wanted to be her perspective, which makes sense with the Courtney storyline as far as like Courtney was the one that made the move and like didn't want to play the games. But like writing it from the Rose's perspective, you would never think to do that because a rose is not a human. But she did it, and she made it make so much sense. And she sounded so good. She sounds so beautiful. She's unbelievable. Olivia Rodrigo is just unbelievable. And I could literally listen to her sing all day long, especially when she's singing like that with a piano behind her and throwing me those runs and those jumping into those high falsettos like that. Man, now I'm going to go jump into Sour and find a way to like go download this song and throw it into that playlist along with Sour, because it just makes too much sense altogether sonically. As far as this episode goes, I'm so glad we got the Gina Ricky thing, but my only question about that is, one, how many episodes are in this season, and is it the last season? Because I'm wondering if we'll get a final conclusion. Is it going to be 7, 8, 9, 10, 4 more episodes? If it's 10 episodes, and I'll definitely be looking out to like as the episodes go to see if, because there still needs to be a present day conversation. We got the past, and I'm glad we got that, but this still makes me question, because she said, "I would never give up on us." And there's still like, there is definitely still hints of, I wanted to make this something more, but at the same time, it could have easily just been us as friends, because the friendship meant a lot to her. Like, she had nobody before that, like at that level. So I get that. And because she's always given up on everything else. And again, it could just be implying that friendship. But the show does this weird thing where it doesn't make that super crystal clear to me. So, I don't know. I guess we'll just keep watching. Otherwise, Ashlyn killed it in here. You know, this is just another fantastic episode. The show continues to be fantastic. I really want Ricky's mom, Ricky's dad, and Jen to get together. They seem so nice together. And Ricky needs to take some tips from his dad, because I think he is destructing his relationship with Nini, as proven by the lyrics in that song. I mean, direct correlations there. I also find it interesting that Olivia Rodrigo wrote the song, and it fits in perfectly with the storyline of the episode. I wonder if they wrote that storyline around Olivia writing that song, because they kind of would have had to if she chose to write the song in that way, or if they just said, hey, this is the storyline, write a song that works around this. Could have worked either way, because she's so good. But yeah, that is all I got for you guys. Miss Jen's the best. She's the best. Her response is just perfect. Like, she's like, no, I know. Trust me. Your mom is thinking of you and would like you to call her. And she's just so matter of fact about it. She's just always, always, always doing the right thing when it comes to these students. Like, every time she does right by them. Top tier character. But they're all so great.
I mean, yes, I was upset at first that Carlos posted it without asking, but yeah. I'm glad he did. And Ricky has been over the top supportive. It's just been
okay.
A lot.
Okay, that's
so what?
Offended? It's a show too, Big Red. It doesn't actually mean anything. But,
it means so much to me. So thank you guys both for your support.
Well, there you go. I'm EJ.
I think it's really cool how you're handling your girlfriend stabbing you in the back like
that. Oh, she's going. Ultra villain.
I love Nini's song.
Okay, but do you love the lyrics?
Oh.
I won't be confined to your point of view. It sounds more like a girl who wants some space. Anyway, let me know if you're looking for one who doesn't.
Whoa! Whoa! Whoa!
Who killed the beast?
Whoa.
Of course he's the one to catch her. He's not Superman, he's just a Superman.
It is now. Goodbye, Zach.
Nini, wait.
I just don't get it, Ricky. Why would you pretend to be supportive and happy about my song?
Yeah, I wasn't pretending. I was trying.
I knew it. I knew you were upset about not being in the song.
I'm just a little relieved that the whole school is not going to hear my girlfriend singing about being kept under glass.
Just a song, Ricky.
I guess we're not
boyfriend and girlfriend anymore.
Yep, just co-anchors. Back to normal.
Howie?
So he's been lying because he would have seen her the whole time. Oh, you a backstabbing boy. Oh, she made the music profile. That's awesome.
Hey, world. Welcome to my first video on this account. I'm Nina.
I love that. Okay, all right. I love that she did that. I love that she, especially after, like, the whole conversation with Ricky there at the end, that she, like, is, like, putting her foot down and moving along with, like, doing what makes her happy. I will say the only thing about that is that she said it's just a song, but you can tell it's how she actually feels, so she shouldn't just say that. She should have gone to him and talked to him about how she feels, you know? That's the only thing I would say about that. But even so, like, Ricky is super passive-aggressive. He's very emotional. He's not good at communicating. He's got a lot of stuff going on. He's a good guy, though. He just got to work through some stuff. And I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen with them. I'm rooting for them, for sure, because I love both characters. But, like, the show's done a good job of, did I know that there was going to be an issue with them? Yes, I did. It just made too much sense in the storyline to do it at some point. But do I know if they'll fix it? Not really, honestly. I don't. I assume they will. But because they have made the issue with Ricky, like, such a deep character thing, like, it's not like there was something that happened. It's more of, like, a buildup of Ricky having these interpersonal issues that caused the two of them to, like, now it's like they just aren't compatible. That's what it is at this point. Like, you think about what is causing this issue, right? It's a lot of characteristic traits of Ricky right now that are causing this main issue between the two of them. That's like a compatibility issue at this point. So that makes me wonder if they'll even fix that, because that's a real issue. That's a real thing that long term could be a problem again down the line, even though they had, like, all those good times. But, you know, if you think about it, like, they were doing better when they were far apart. It's ironic, but they had that space. Now that they're, like, together, it's gotten worse. So I just find that also ironic. And that's just me also, like, kind of using real life relationships that you see and, you know, even go through yourself and compare with all that. So I find that really interesting. The Gina EJ thing seems to just be a friendship, nothing serious. Even though they, like, left the camera on EJ super long a couple episodes ago, I think that even though they did the whole fake boyfriend girlfriend thing here, I really do think it's just a friendship. But I still wouldn't be surprised if they go in the direction of it. But she needs the friend right now, so that's awesome. We got no Ricky Gina stuff in this, which is interesting, because we didn't even, especially after last episode when we got that flashback, and I'm still waiting for them to have this talk about that. We got none of that. Maybe we'll get it at some point. I assume we would, but it's like it wasn't even a thing here. This woman, Lily, I think her name is evil. She is pure evil. Like, that conversation with Ricky, talking about, you know, if you're looking for something different, or however she said it, like, come to me. Wow. Damn, that's a low place to go. And she's done some low stuff. And then the other guy, like, I don't know if he can, is it Howie? Courtney's guy there? I don't know if he can redeem that. That's tough. Through and through, I don't know. It's probably one of my lesser favorite episodes of the season so far, but that's more of, like, a compliment to that there's been so many really great episodes in this season. It's been, like, they had, like, a string where they were all so good. Like, before this one, there was, like, four or five straight that were just, like, wow. It just wouldn't stop with the great episodes. This one's, like, a notch below those, but I still enjoyed it. That Miss Jen situation is, I'm glad that that's not going to be a thing, because that would make me No, I wouldn't want to see that. Because the guy just clearly is, like, obviously he stole the mask. He's a child. And, yeah, other than that, I didn't take much away from this episode. Aside from Ricky and Nini. I enjoyed that. And I probably enjoyed that most because they're two of, like, the better actors in the show. They just do such a good job of, like, displaying their emotions. I mean, Olivia Rodrigo is incredible. Like, just her face. Like, her face when she's just so disappointed in Ricky is so good. She plays off of Joshua so well. The two of them are just, like, tremendous. Like, you can center an entire High School Musical movie, High School Musical 4 or whatever. I don't know. You know what I mean. Around just the two of those actors, Joshua and Olivia. And it would be tremendous because they're both so good. I talk about that all the time, though. The whole cast is so good.
Have you seen Nini?
Every time I open Instagram.
Yeah, thanks. I mean, here in school.
Oh, that was the biggest part of the last episode for me.
No, Nini and I didn't leave things on a great note the way last that ended. Week. Well, I'm not sure what's going to happen when I see her today.
Did you make that channel because of everything I said about keeping yourself under glass? I mean, is this you unglassed?
No offense, Ricky, but it's not actually about you.
Yeah, exactly. Not every...
is the channel called Nina?
It's so hard to watch.
Good morning, Eastside.
Personal?
It is personal. To me, Nina's my given name.
That's awesome.
Who is this guy?
Oh.
Let me know if you're down to collab.
Oh, no! No! Oh,
God, oh, no.
I was hoping that you knew.
God.
No one heard that.
Such a beautiful...
Yeah, Gina and I have gotten friendship. A little bit closer since North High.
When started designing all your own clothes when you were just 3 years old.
And?
And you have always known what's best for you. Trust yourself. I know I do.
Can we get more of Courtney's mom on the show, please? Because she just stole this episode from me in this 1 minute scene.
Nini, look, I'm here to, like, try and fix whatever's going on between us. I mean, like, obviously we both want to make this work, right? We're doing everything we can. I know that's why you came back from Yak.
Stop. I love you and I missed you, but
That's not why she came back. He's so full of himself.
When I called you.
I was already in Salt Lake.
Come on.
Got off the bus before you ever called.
What are you saying? You came back in spite of me?
No. When you called, I didn't want to hurt your feelings.
So being honest is a problem now. Look, where are we?
I don't know, but hearing you say you wished I would come home and leave my dream behind was like a lot of feelings at once.
Okay, I'm a little lost here too. I don't even know what's going on with you. And honestly, it's kind of freaking me out.
Whoa.
First, you wait to the last second to tell me you're even leaving for Yak.
And then you went behind my back and asked Miss Jen to give me a part in the show, even though I told you I didn't want one.
And then you wrote that Rose song about us instead of just telling me how you're feeling.
And when my song got cut, it was like you didn't even care.
And then I found out you didn't even come home to be with me.
I was trying to do the right thing.
So was I.
Guys, you might want to take it down a couple notches. You're scaring the real customers.
I'm out of here.
Oh, wow.
I know.
The contrast in how each of these relationships are going are incredibly drastically different.
What about food service?
Honestly, the only other thing that makes me happy is you. But, like, I knew you were going to be a big star, so maybe it's not.
This is such a great episode.
It'd be crazy not to hire.
He's so awkward. She's going to have to make the move.
I'm going to put this together, and I'll send you the video tonight.
Thank you, Benjamin, for everything. You don't get enough credit around here.
Why didn't you tell anyone?
I didn't really get in.
But your dad...
I mean, I did, but only because he made it happen.
Okay, that makes a lot of sense, yeah. He didn't get in the way he wants to get in.
Right, isn't that what you always wanted? Okay, so what do you want?
I don't know.
They're so good for each other in that way, whether it's as friends or more. Like,
close your eyes.
They're really good for each other.
Yeah.
Based on their differences, like, they balance each other out in those ways.
So,
man, I can't believe this treehouse is still standing.
Is this after that?
My mom's built stuff to last.
Are we in the same timeline? Because...
Do you remember how big this thing felt when we were little?
Is she going to break up with him? This is in the same timeline, right? I'm so lost.
So?
What did your results say?
Hmm? If you want to stay for dinner?
I deleted a comment on your new Insta today.
What?
I'm sorry. At this point. Honestly, I don't like who I'm becoming. Chasing you down all the time.
I don't like running away.
Oh.
Look, space to figure things out.
Last time we took a break, we ended up broken up.
Are we breaking up?
I don't want to hold you back.
Can I just hold you now?
Damn, she's good. Oh my god, this woman is good at acting.
Hopeless as my dream dies, as the time flies, love lost it. No goodness improved me, no power on earth if I can't love her. Then who?
Thank you, please. Thank you, thank you. Longer,
I'm not going to Duke.
Courtney's serious face at the end. She's got trust stuff. Oh my gosh, guys. Wow. I can't believe, what was the point of the last episode? The last episode was so bad compared to this. You just didn't, like, this is my favorite episode. Yeah, like this one, I know I say that a lot, I know, but when I say it, I mean it, because each episode gets better. This episode is incredible. It's incredible. It's so good. First of all, I will say that the acting in this episode was like the best it's been. First of all, Olivia Rodrigo and that scene with Joshua Bassett in the treehouse. Fuck. That was her best performance in a scene yet. Benjamin was incredible in this episode. Like, he's been the same character throughout the show with like hints of easing off and moments like his conversation, the season finale last season with Big Red, with like helping him out, you know, with the lights and stuff and the stage production, and then like the conversation with EJ, and then helping out Miss Jen with a couple things. Like, he's, you know, here and there, but nothing too, like, it's still like he's still him, but like just like cooler now and like not as like stuck up and uptight and all that stuff. But this is a whole new version of him in this episode, a whole new version where he brought some walls down, and it was just, it was so well done. Like, I wish he would have gone for it, but it makes sense that he totally didn't, because he still is that person at the end of the day, like that has like this wall up. And I like that they resolved the Big Red and Ashlyn thing. Like, that makes sense, because the two of them are just too good to be like having it, that those kinds of issues. Like, they both are just the like purest human beings, the both of them on both ends. Like, Big Red is like my favorite character. I think they're my two favorite characters, actually, Ashlyn and Big Red. And Courtney's been someone that's been sneaking up my favorite character ladder. So to see her have the moment that she had, or get like such prevalent opportunities in this episode, and then have her mom come in and be like so badass and like such an awesome character in that little scene that she had. I loved this episode. Wow. And Ricky made me I was cringing so hard. I can't tell you enough. Like, being that guy that just starts a yelling match in a public, like, that is the... First of all, deleting the thing off the phone, it's like then being like doing the yelling match thing and just being completely so close. Like, everything he's doing is like huge red flag stuff that you just can never, ever, ever do. Like, ever. Like, you just can't be that guy. You can't. And he just kept doing it. And then the yelling thing was like the tip of the iceberg for me. And I was just... The cringe was on 1,000 for me. It was really hard to watch. Really hard. Like, I literally had to stop watching for a sec because it was so hard for me to watch like this young man doing all these things. That's how bad it was for me. And then they go to the treehouse and like everything seems so relaxed. And it was the first time we saw them after the diner, or after the pizza shop, where I'm thinking we have like a flashback. What's going on? But it makes sense. So, like, she wanted to... just talk. I don't know if she planned on breaking up with him. I don't really think she did. I think she just wanted to talk and see where it went. But Ricky was so like honest for the first time, like honest with himself for the first time, where he's like, I don't like, you know, I'm pulling, like, I don't like these feelings. Like, I deleted the text. Like, I don't like that I did that. All these things. Like, he's super honest, and he never has been really with himself anyway. I'm not saying he's a dishonest person. I don't think he's consciously dishonest at all. I just think he's unhonest with himself about like who he's become this whole season. It's just really insecure person, like he said, that is scared, that has been like holding on, like protecting this him and Nini thing and not letting her see herself outside of that. And he could have like continued to love her and have this amazing relationship while still like rooting for her and pushing her to be the best version of herself, but like everything he was doing was so wrong in the approach. So, like, it makes me wonder if they can, like, I know I said in the last episode, I believe it was last episode or two episodes ago, I don't remember, that they're so different. Like, ultimately, I don't think that they're a good match as characters. They're just so different as people. But, like, perhaps if he can actually be honest with himself, then maybe they could make that work. But I don't know. I don't know if it's a permanent breakup. I kind of do think it should be. As hard as like that was for both of them, like, he's broken. She, again, her performance, she was clearly shattered. Wow, I'm still overwhelmed. This whole episode, Courtney, the guy, I forgot his name, but him singing at the end, he sounds incredible. I know I'm missing something. This is genuinely a fucking perfect episode. I can't believe how good this episode was. Okay, let's move on. Let's go to the next episode. Because, wow, times a million. Fuck, that was so good. I was getting emotional several times throughout that episode. The Gina EJ thing. I didn't even talk about EJ. EJ's had like this unreal character development when you think about where he was in the very beginning. Even like when he bought the plane ticket for Gina, I was surprised. I remember being like super shocked about it, but I still wasn't like, I still like found his character to be kind of like a not serious. Like, I wasn't taking him seriously still. I was just like, oh, that's a great moment for EJ. Wow, I moved right on. Didn't think anything of it. And then coming into season two, he still like was a similar person where it was just kind of like comic relief for me, his character. But like, he's like, there's so much to him. That's the beauty of this show, is there's so much to all these characters. Like, Gina is the definition of there's so much to her throughout the show. And that's why the two of them like work so well in that way, because of that balance, like how he bloomed so late and we got her blooming really early in that way because she's so in touch with like her emotions, and he hasn't been up until this moment, but she brings that out of him. And like, I love like the play on like the relationships either breaking apart or fixing, when we have like Big Red and Ash and fixing, and then we have kind of Benjamin and Miss Jen kind of seemingly coming together. Hopefully Miss Jen, I don't know if she picked up all the hints or she did, but like, maybe wants him to make the move. I don't know. We'll see. Or maybe she wouldn't want to do the whole coworker thing. There's still some things up in the air there, but like Nini and Ricky breaking apart, and then Courtney and the guy that was singing there at the end, who sounds amazing once again. Wow. Like, we can't even tell there because her face was so like, you know, I stood there and listened to this. Okay, I hear your point. But you could tell like, I still have, there's still like, you betrayed my trust. And that's a big deal, and it's so hard for me to come back from that. So, like, there's a lot to think from this episode, and I'm going to for real go to the next episode now. Okay, episode 9, Spring Break. Let's do it. Still not recovered from that at last episode, by the way.
Dad told me.
Great. So the only time you two talk to each other is to gossip about me.
Sorry. To hear that it's over.
Man, she's rough.
Maybe it isn't yet. I don't know.
So, damn. Is Miami home?
Nah, Denver is. Miami spring break, if my flight ever takes off.
Shoot.
What?
I thought I packed her granola bar. I've told you not to use that tone with me. You were in charge of the documents. Dad's passport and credit card.
He said you were in charge.
Because
you've
never kissed anyone. I don't buy that.
You'd be surprised. Hey, you're stalling.
You're an only child.
Wrong. I actually have a much older brother.
Sometimes the last best thing we can do for someone we truly love is to let them go.
Oh, ow.
What it's worth.
Ow. Ow. Oh, that one hurt me. Shit.
It seems Zach Roy has yet another trick up his sleeve.
Miss Jen, they just dropped the video on their Instagram.
Are you ready?
Is Carlos going to be?
Kids, Nini is going to share her screen so we can all watch together.
You okay? We just finished up a video and I'm sending you a link in your messages. Check it out. Is your phone like off, dude? You missed out on this video we made. Hope you're okay.
You gotta take some time to breathe. Let your heart off the leash. Cause it ain't meant to shine in one place.
Remind yourself of time. I'm roaring louder than thunder.
Okay.
But you'll never see it coming. See it coming. As long as we got each other.
Look at Gina dancing.
Watch out cause you ain't seen nothing. But you'll never see it.
This is dope.
You're cute too. Like beyond, but I'm probably not going to see you again, am I?
We'll always have the VIP lounge.
Whoever gets that first kiss is gonna be a really lucky guy.
Yeah, I think, I think I'm ready. We're getting there. Trick is not to care.
Oh. Oh. See? Told you didn't mean that. You can't mean that. That's not a real thing.
Tear the treehouse down, give up the fantasy.
Okay, we know what this is about.
Since the day we met, glad we took a chance making our own world. Perfectly imperfect like it had to be.
I love when he gets these moments.
And I hope you find better. I can't forget us. Can't pretend we ain't broken.
No, I want that better again. I can't not replay that better riff.
It couldn't last forever. And I hope you find better. I can't forget both untied. It'll take time.
Oh, the way he lightens up on take is such a nice choice. Hold up, he goes like it'll and then really soft on take. It's just so nice.
Cuts up both untied. It'll take time. It'll take time.
Josh. Oh.
Excuse me, have you seen a Duke sweatshirt anywhere?
What are you doing at the airport?
Look how wanted Gina is. Everyone wants you, Gina, and you deserve that. What another really good episode. The last episode was better. But this was a really good episode, though. It does not take away from this. Especially, like, first of all, the performance, I was thinking super Brady Bunch with the way it was, like, edited into all the screens. But smart, because they started off with the Zoom calls, so they played on that. And, like, everyone's in a different location as well. Spring Break, it makes sense. It's a really cool way to incorporate it. I really like the editing. But, like, the song was very... What I love about this show is that, like, Joshua Bassett's song here at the end here, right, is, like, fucking... And, like, so many... The Rose song, right? Like, the song that Nini sang on the bus earlier in the season. Like, there's been so many I forgot the name of that song, but I absolutely do listen to that song somewhat frequently. There's so many songs that this show has that are so non-musical sounding, like as far as like not traditional high school musical, where it's like you can hear them on the radio is really what I'm trying to say. And I love that about the show. And the thing about the show too is that it's so good. Like, it's so much better than you would think it should be just looking at what it is. And if you watch like the show is better than the High School Musical, the movies, in my opinion. So if you just like watch those movies, you would think the show is like kind of corny, just like those movies are kind of corny, though they're enjoyable, but they're corny. This show's not that at all. Like, it's not even in like it's a TV show, like legitimate TV show, really good with really great acting, real storylines, like real character growth, like real emotions. Like, I've cried several times watching this show. But point being is that the music on the show is oftentimes like radio type of like big sounding, like legitimate music. And I often forget that, like, it's my favorite part of the show. And the reason I forget all the time is because of how good the show is. Like, I forget a lot about the music on the show because the show is such a like legitimate show and it's really good. But then I hear music and it's like the Joshua song here at the end, I'll hear it and I'll be like, oh wait, like this is actually my favorite part about the show, is that they have these Ashlyn, Courtney, I don't know their actors' names, but like Olivia Rodrigo and Joshua Bassett, like they have these wildly talented singers that are really, really good at making music and recording music. But yeah, so just want to throw that point out there. The one song with everyone in the edit, though, singing together through the Zoom, was much more like High School to Musical, like sort of musical sounding. Like, I still like really enjoyed it. My biggest takeaway from this episode is a couple things. Ricky and his mom, definitely, probably the overall biggest takeaway, because like that's just really important. Those are really important scenes, honestly. I think it's really important for Ricky's character at this point to have like that connection with his mom, and just like, because a lot of that situation is part of like what builds up this like insecurity in him and a lot of these pent-up emotions that he does take out on other people, particularly Nene. So like he needs that as a character. Interesting to hear him earlier on in the episode say that he doesn't know if it's over, but then like towards the end it does seem like after the convo with his mom that it's more of an acceptance of it being over. So I still carry myself with the question of, are they gonna fix it, and do I even really want to see them fix it? I honestly don't know. I kind of don't really care to see them fix it because we've already been through this. Like, it would be the second time, even though it'd be for a different reason now. But I will say, if they do end up fixing it, I'll be open to it depending on how they do it. So we'll see. We're pretty open-minded about everything here. So whatever happens, happens. My other biggest takeaway from all this is the paper airplane that he gave Gina, this new guy that she met in this episode, who ended up being like a pretty decent-seeming guy. Like, she's got to get to know him some more, of course. Because she said, like, got to stick around. So, like, that's the key. Was that paper airplane, did it have his phone number on it? Because that's my guess. And EJ clearly has feelings for her. Are we going to have a situation where she ends up, like, texting the guy, if that's his phone number? I don't even know. I think it is. Like, it doesn't make sense for him to just give her the airplane like that. I think in the next episode she'll open it up. It'll be a phone number. Yeah, it's got to be, right? And then they'll text. And then, like, feel it, like, real feelings will be there. But then EJ will try and make a move. That would be really fascinating to see. And then see, like, which direction she goes in. Because she seemed to, like, actually dig the guy. They would, like, not just dig him. Like, there was, like, an actual connection there, which was really cool to see. Like, they were so similar. And on the contrary, her and EJ are so different, which I found so interesting in the last episode. So that's just, like, really, really cool dynamic. I really like what they did there. But I also think her and EJ, like, are a great kind of fit together. I really do. And she has more of a level of trust with EJ because she knows him, so there's less question marks. I don't know, I'll see where they go with it. I just like the touch and like where it could go. I'm really into that. These most recent couple episodes are one of the greatest examples of why I love the comments in the Patreon on these episodes is, well, one, I had no idea that that was Courtney's actual mom. Like, that is so cool, and I feel like that's part of why maybe I just connected with it so easily. It just felt so natural, you know, like you didn't think for a second this wouldn't be her mom. It just was such a natural, she played it, she killed that role for the few seconds she was in it, because it's not a role, it's like real life. So I found that out, and then plus the just the perspective of, like, I'm over here thinking that this new guy is introduced as a potential love interest for Gina. But I actually agree with a lot of the comments that were that I saw for this most recent episode, where it's more of perhaps like opening Gina's mind to feelings she probably does have for EJ, especially with him showing up there at the end. So again, shout out to you guys for those comments, and like shout out to High School Musical, the series here, for some killer episodes lately. My goodness, they've gotten so good, especially the last two. Like, that is a that's a nice run of episodes to lead us up to, like, build the emotions and really just build it so nicely. And then here we only have a couple episodes left, I think three left. So let's do it, guys. Let's jump right in.
For you know I won't run away.
This is how you start one of these episodes off.
Belle, I...
Yes?
We're the stars of our respective shows.
Oh, okay.
Come on, Rick. He's got too much integrity for this.
So good at being a leading man.
Don't fall for this.
You think so?
Yeah, everyone was so happy when you got the Beast. It's because you were so supportive of that boy at the auditions. You know, the one who couldn't stand upright?
The one who's right in front of you.
Hug emoji, okay?
I got it.
That was such an
super weird,
awkward interaction.
It was.
Disguise the transition.
Wow, won't that take a while?
Why is he here?
I mean, if you are.
I guess I could sleep over tonight.
You guys, what are we making?
This is such a, like, this is literally defining boys versus girls in productivity.
To slowly spin Ricky around on so that we can change the fabric on his cape while he spins.
What are the chocolates?
Ooh. Oh, let's approach this.
I thought Ricky sent me some chocolates on Valentine's Day and it kind of melted a little as a friend. Why did I never hear about this? It wasn't a big deal.
Oh shoot! This is the good for you, Olivia Rodrigo. Here you go, face.
And good for you, it's like you never even met me.
It's not too late to fix all of that.
Thank you, Benjamin. Truly.
Speak, sir, speak.
Teacher power, right?
Oh, friend zone.
Indeed. Can you hit a high C?
That's like the bottom of my range. Why?
Take a seat.
Needs help with the ladder.
Man, they both don't want to get hurt so bad.
Do you want to get risotto with me sometime?
Whoa, he just went for it. Benjamin, it's your turn after this. Time.
Yeah. Yeah, risotto sounds great.
Okay.
Whatever happens, when all said and done, be that choose you.
How are these two not the stars of this whole season?
Why would I go anywhere else? How crazy I am. Somehow you understand.
Yes, great. Don't you worry, a great choice. Bring it back to that moment.
Thank you.
Oh, Ricky.
Bro.
If he falls from there, that's kind of dangerous. No, not from there.
Uh-oh. Ah!
That's a painful spot to drop from. Okay, guys. This felt like another one of those episodes that kind of builds you up. I really enjoyed it though. Like, I really enjoyed it. Definitely much less intense than some of the episodes lately, particularly the last two. But still, like, very necessary, it feels like, for the build-up. Like, you had the Gina-EJ thing. Like, they both kind of finally, like... Like, they couldn't keep carrying on this way, where they're both just petrified to let themselves into each other. And now they're going for Soto. I love that. Really light on the Nini in this episode, which I'm fine with, because they've done such an amazing job at building up all the other characters. Like, Seb and Carlos have literally been, like, the stars of the season. Like... You know, Gina, EJ, that's the thing. It's like Gina, EJ, Nini, Ricky, of course, like Seb, Carlos. I would say those three couples in, like, have been, and not even like, it's not just been about them as couples, even as individuals. They've done so good at building them up. And Courtney as well, we can't forget about her. It's just this season has been incredible. With, like, season one was so Nini, Ricky heavy. This season has just, like, knocked it out the park with building up all the other characters so much better, and, like, the interpersonal relationships and the romance aspects of everything. It's, but, like, then you could have an episode like this where Nini barely has lines, and it's still just, like, a great episode. And, yeah, like, big episode for Ricky as far as letting... go to an extent, like the pan over from EJ saying what he said about the best thing he ever did was let go of Nini, like, and then the thing he was proudest of anyway, and then you have the song connection, and then what, like, you could see it really hitting Ricky even more, like, just, I don't need to be, you know, like, if I sing her the song, it's not really letting her go, it's just hurting her even more, like, putting her through some more emotional turmoil. So I'm gonna give this to somebody else, and, like, a different song, obviously a different version, but give something to Carlos, who actually needs it, and do it for the better. Like, what, just, man, the Benjamin Miss Jen thing, kind of a lot of the same stuff as far as building them up but not really going anywhere with it, like a lot of the same, her zoning him once again and him not making that move, but they are making it clear that he's clearly, like, doing, like, there's some, like, he's feeling something clearly. What else happened in this episode? I think that's it. Yeah, like, there wasn't, like, a big B story, you know, in this episode. It was a lot of everyone, but I still enjoyed that, though. Like, for the first few minutes, I was like, are we just gonna spend the whole episode figuring out this transformation? But they slowly worked in these things, the more emotional stuff, like they do, and the character building stuff, and... I don't know if we're just gonna, like, a lot of you pointed out in the comments, and I completely agree, how the Gina Ricky thing just kind of dissipated, like, it just, they just completely ignored it out of nowhere when they were building it up so much, like, the interaction anyway, like, some kind of resolution, and they were just like, whatever, and they kind of brought it up again in this episode, so I don't know if that's them, it still wouldn't make sense, because Gina's so moved on, like, she's got this, she look at her smile, she's so happy, but then again, you have Nini being really upset. But that's one thing I haven't, like, I've been kind of like, what's going on as far, like, what are we doing here as far as that Gina Ricky thing? But now, because they did that, now I'm wondering if they're just going to have Nini be like, kind of pissed off at Gina in the scene, like, it was clear. But if we're just going to, like, leave that alone now, so, like, now I've lost trust in them from that sense, like, the show, I'm saying. But I don't know, we'll see. It would be interesting to see them push that more in the last couple episodes, I should say. But I don't know where they would go with that. Because Nini and Gina aren't incredibly close to begin with, you know? So I don't know how much strain that can cause between the two of them already. But I do appreciate the fact that I don't know where that's going to go, which is kind of cool, right? We don't want predictability here, which the show does a good job at veering away from. Okay, but great episode, guys. Really enjoyed the build-up. Let me know what you think, as always. And let's keep it going.
Hey, happy opening day. Hey, good luck.
Whoa, that looks...
Happy opening. See ya.
It's so official.
Hey, and for the record, I have a good luck note for you. Just gotta sign it.
Oh, yep, same.
Honestly, it wasn't easy summing up our entire emotional journey up to this point. So but it's not even, I think I finally got it
right. I think a song is the only way. So the last season, they also did the last two episodes being like the show. So it's cool that they did it again. Date.
Hello.
Got it.
What do you wear on a date?
I love that she's just going for it, calling it that.
And the candle.
Sorry, I'm late.
Just some dry heaving.
Oh, Pepto.
Dry?
Oh my gosh, I didn't even see his face.
Peek-a-boo.
Oh, Lily. I keep forgetting she exists for some reason.
Did we forget to build a moat around the school?
Oh, I just came by to support my favorite actor.
I love that line from him.
You know, Ricky, when my dad got remarried, I couldn't look at the new wife for a month. Now she is literally the only sane member of my family.
including you?
For some reason, I feel like she meant that.
Prince,
sorry, I should...
Get your head in the game.
Get you. That was nicely done.
Floppy, fat, and lazy. You walked in, oops a daisy.
It's a guest. Sakes alive, whom I'll be blessed and freshly pressed.
Oh, Courtney, bringing it.
And my dear, that's fine with me. While the cups do their soft shoeing, I'll be bubbling, I'll be brewing.
Oh, it's the perfect energy switch.
Did you see me performing up there?
I did, yes.
Did you enjoy it?
Very much.
What's his deal?
Okay, well, enjoy your air.
He's acting like
he's
possessed.
Thank you.
Nini's been like the support system all episode.
Okay.
From the start, with all the notes.
Has
anyone asked for your autograph? We don't get many celebs in Salt Lake.
Oh, celebs. I can try, and I don't...
I'm just really happy to see your face.
A bit alarming. Who'd have ever thought that this could be?
Oh, she's killing us.
Look, we're all just really glad that Gigi has a big brother figure in her life.
What?
Is that what Gina said about me?
EJ, just go on your date, EJ. Don't let that. That's hearsay stuff.
Bop to the top.
I know it's here. I preset it. What's wrong?
My harness is missing.
The new one for the transformation.
What?
No, this can't be happening.
Oh, she has the harness. I said don't trust her. It's to be continued. I said do not trust this woman under any circumstances. Yeah, did I believe that the comment about her mother remarrying was, or her father remarrying? I don't remember. I think it was her father remarrying. And then her new stepmom was like the only sane person now. Yeah, whatever. That was genuine in the moment, maybe. Even whether it was or wasn't. Don't trust her. Gosh. She's giving you no reason. And therefore, you continue to just not trust her. Oh, man. Also, what was that phone call that Benjamin got? I can't stop thinking about that. That was something. I don't have a lot to say about this episode. It built to the next one, like, to the extreme almost. Which is fine, because the next one's the season finale. Like, that's where everything's going to go down. Then again, like, the second-to-last episode of the first season was super dramatic. Much more than this one, actually. Which makes me... Like, you think back to that to an extent, but then this has just been a much different season, which I've enjoyed more, so it's not a bad thing. The EJ thing, like, he just needs to go on the date, like, read Gina's body language. Think about how happy she was when you asked her to that date and how clearly it's like, you know, this is, she's into you. But yeah, he's gonna let that get into his head, and I don't know what's gonna happen in the next episode. And then we have, I don't know if Gina and Ricky, this exchange of the mask and this empty note, she hasn't been able to tell him how she feels or like describe their journey, I guess, both of them clearly, but because that's a lot, you can't just write that on a card, it's too much, they've been through too much. But it doesn't feel at all like they're building that up to be like some season finale, like them reconciling and getting that together. Like, it doesn't feel at all like they're gonna do that. So I don't know. I'm truly kind of in the dark on where we're going, and I like that. Let's get a season finale of me just being surprised. Miss Jen obviously freaked out a little bit there at the end. I think she'll be okay. I just don't know what the Benjamin phone call was. That's what my main question is right now. And just to see how everything turns out. Yeah. All right, guys. I'll see you just for the season finale. How exciting is that? It's not the series finale, though, because someone told me that that Olivia Rodrigo signed up for 3 seasons. So as far as I concerned and understand is that there is going to be one more season. But that's what that's a couple comments I read. I don't know for sure. Okay, so we have a bit of a cliffhanger in the last episode, and we've got a lot of theories too. Like, so many theories amongst everyone within the fandom of this show. So, from Gina and the brother, and what role he's going to end up playing in this last episode, to how that affected EJ and what choice he's going to make, and the phone call to Ben, and who took the harness, did Owie play a role, and then Mrs. Evil and what her role in all of this is. There's a lot going on, and then we have the whole Ricky Nini thing, which is kind of like a nothing at this point, I guess, even though they touched on it a little bit with the cards. Let's just do it. Yeah. Okay.
Hey, give it up for our star! Oh, you guys.
Your name in lights.
This is what you were doing in between scenes all night.
Oh my god.
Yeah? I'm blown away.
Oh, it's just an extra?
That's what's going on. I couldn't take my eyes off you tonight.
One of you said that in the comments, and...
During the show, it seems I've been recommended for a spot in the Caltech doctoral robotics program.
That's amazing. Congrats.
Hash Caswell spoke very highly of me.
They weren't supposed to say that part.
So what are you going to do?
I really don't know.
Yo, Gaston!
Gang, tonight.
Man, does this mean we got to reschedule one more time?
We could, or we could just play it by ear. You know?
Dear Ricky.
Dear Nini.
Oh, come on.
Did we seriously write the same thing?
I know it's been quite a journey.
You said long semester.
The weird little tiff.
I just had this big, dumb plan to go out with EJ tonight, and he just canceled.
Truth is, we're all lucky to know you.
You're still doing it.
Doing what?
The two best actors.
Lifting other people up.
The two best actors on the show for me.
Did it all night.
Right here.
A chocolates thing.
Oh, no, that's... Honestly, it was more about me and you than it was about me and him.
When you stole all my stuff. Like, gave it back. You're a really solid person, Nini.
Oh, her brother.
There's someone I think you should meet.
Yeah, that's right.
You have my blessing. If you want to date him again. I mean, he's a crank and he can't make chicken, but and you make him happy.
Look at this.
Are you happy?
That's a loaded question for Ricky. It's not fair. That's major character growth for him now.
Well, you deserve to be.
So do you.
Oh, and it finally meets the end. But there is something in the summer wind, a moment to begin. To fly, I got a second chance to fall. What can make the tide turn?
I'm safe when I'm on the run.
The way Ricky comes in with the begin again, and then EJ comes in, and then Gina comes in, and Olivia is singing. I'm using the wrong names. You know what I mean, though.
In case we never speak again, I like you, Ricky.
That's nice.
I like your big brown eyes and your big round hair. Sometimes people deserve a second chance.
You stole the harness in the last episode. What is up with this girl? She's, like, just really good at acting genuine. Shout out to the actress.
Can you guys imagine if they actually?
Because she almost tricked me with the stepmom. The step.
Don't sue me, but I kind of don't care anymore.
Give me that. We got a pizza oven.
Well, to be honest, the only thing keeping me from running to California is
earthquakes.
You.
Oh.
Us.
Wait.
The possibility of us.
Okay, we're right out with it. It's kind of an obvious way to fix it, I guess.
Hey, Jamie. It's Nini.
This is interesting.
Hey, Lily. It's me. Ricky.
Oh, how do we feel
EJ!
About that?
Will you be my first kiss?
Yeah. You are the music in me.
Oh, yes.
Sing it, dude.
You know the words once upon a time. Na na na. Na 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 na, yeah. You are the music in me.
That's so cool that this is like literally just the casting they're doing. Like that last, let me make sure they don't have like EJ tap dance or not Big Red tap dancing at the end here. Okay. That last little cutscene after the season was over was perfect, especially that right there, the music and me performance, because it's them as a cast as opposed to like them as actors performing. And it personifies my favorite thing about this show. And that's that these friendships are all so genuine, and you can tell, like, and I've gotten so many comments about too that they're all friends off camera, and it's so obvious, and it makes this show so much better to me, and, like, it makes it not just so much better, but, like, it gives it all the genuine emotion. Like, every time you have the emotional scenes in the show, I buy it every time, and that's just not always the case with TV. It's usually not the case, actually. And this show really nails that, and I think it's because of those off-screen relationships that this cast has, and it's such a beautiful thing to have. It's such a rare thing to have. A couple kind of obvious fixes with the way the Howie thing happened. Cool, that worked out. The EJ and Gina thing, okay, a little obvious the way they went about it, but it's fine. At least they fixed it. I would have been so upset if they didn't fix that, because there's just no good reason for that. So she had her first kiss. We have, I guess, what it feels like is it feels open-ended for season 3, but it also feels like they're writing Olivia Rodrigo off with the whole go work with my brother or call my brother. She's on the phone, you know, and I like the whole cut into like her on the phone, then Ricky on the phone, cutting in between everyone kind of moving on into like second chances, which is the name of the episode, which is really clever. And then also they left it open-ended too with the triangle of Miss Jen, Benjamin and Ricky's dad. So it feels like there will be a season 3. I feel like I can comfortably say that. It just feels like it won't be with Olivia Rodrigo, you know? Because it'd be almost impossible to pull that off with touring, and there's no way she won't tour, right? You know, I'm not going to get into COVID Delta variant stuff. Hopefully, you know, none of that stuff cancels things, but you know what I mean, like, everything willing that works out. I just can't picture her not touring with the success that she had musically. So that's what it feels like. It feels like this was a very natural way to write her out. And a lot of you said that she still wants to be involved and enjoys the directing side of things or whatever. So maybe she can still be involved as a producer or come in and be involved in a couple episodes or something. Or some kind of come in for a couple episodes and perform something at some point. You know, like that Rose song little interaction she had with Gina. My favorite scene of this whole episode was the interaction with Gina and Olivia, or Gina and Nini. I forget the name of the actress that plays Gina. So we'll say Gina and Nini. They're the two best actors on the show for me. So them having that interaction it was a beautiful thing. It was everything. And it kind of resolved, like, we've all been a little upset with the whole, or not, you know, it is kind of what it is. They just kind of let it go with the Gina, Ricky, Nini thing. But I feel like the interaction kind of ties it up. You know, you don't really need to have Ricky there, because Nini said it herself, this is really about the two of them more than her and Ricky in that moment. You know, her and Ricky aren't a thing anymore. So I really appreciated that. And I loved all this, guys. I got nothing else to say. Like, you guys have been with me for every episode. You know how I felt about the show. I want a season 3 so bad. So I'm excited that it looks like we're going to get that whenever that happens. And now that I've got kind of a little bit more time without doing the show, now I can dive into like all the, so I know there was like a Christmas special. I didn't do that. Or was it a Thanksgiving special? The Olivia Rodrigo unreleased stuff. Like, there's a lot of stuff now that I can kind of, you know, when I sit down and I would have done this, I can sit down and do that and get you guys that stuff and check that stuff out myself, because I've been waiting to do that. Please leave me your thoughts. Let me know how you felt about this finale. I really enjoyed it. I've loved the whole season. It did very much feel like, I saw some comments too about how how we've been feeling about sort of Nini's character as the season's been progressing, and it does, like, it feels like it has been, like, written away from her, but I feel like that was intentionally done to set themselves up for season three without her. So from that perspective, I do kind of get it. How can I leave without not mentioning Ricky and Evil Girl? Are we buying that? You know, like, are we buying into her? I'm not. I just can't. Because I already almost did and got fooled. And she didn't even bring up the harness thing. Or are they going to go into a season three and kind of do a thing where, like, she does end up being, like, it's, you know, have real feelings and they do like each other. But, like, then Ricky finds out about the harness and then can't forgive her. And that ends up being their issue. You know what I mean? I don't know. It's just hard. She's such a liar, you know? But that's all I got for you guys. Thank you for joining me on this journey so much. And please let me know how you felt about this episode as a finale and what you think about moving forward with all these open-ended sort of situations. Love you guys.